NCTV45, The Train, anytime on your time.
Hey, welcome to the Padula Show Extra featuring Jay and Jay.
Just Jay.
For right now.
Mm-hmm.
And as we promised yesterday, you'll get this opportunity to interview people like Mary. Mary has been working here for 30 years at the Main Street Clothery downtown Newcastle. Did I say that? Pronounce that correctly?
Yes,
Clothery?
You did. Yeah.
Main Street. Beautiful suits.
I prefer the French version of Clothier.
Clothier.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very nice. Mary, pleased to meet you.
She doesn't like to be touched.
She doesn't?
Mm-mm. Okay. Mike said that.
Well, listen, you know, you've been here for 30 years. Can you just please share with the audience the fashion that has come and gone throughout the 30 years? Yes. Yeah, I remember.
Bell-bottoms, yeah.
Yeah, the bell-bottoms. Were you like a big 60s person? Oh, you were, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, I tell you what, you talk about.
She's engaging, isn't she?
She is, but you know what I like? And Mary, please, I don't want to put words in your mouth. What I really like about her, though, you really became very fashionable, very reserved. What do you, you know? And you've been working. I could see you're getting ready for spring fashions. Are these part of the spring fashions? Those are Christmas.
Those would be Christmas sweaters.
No, it's Christmas sweaters. But sorry,
I was told that she is actually regaling us with the Hillary Clinton line of clothing that they're coming out with soon.
Wow,
as you can see, it's very nice.
Wow, and listen, I don't want to get into politics with you because, like I said, it wouldn't be fair to you. And plus, you're working, and I don't want to get Mike upset with us because we're taking time out of your day. What is that? No, I don't have change for a 10. I don't have change for a 10. I'm sorry. Do you want a coffee or something while we're doing it? No, just a water. You know what? I'm sorry, but I left everything out in the Escalade. I do apologize for that, and I don't want you to think that, you know, J&J on, you know, the Padula Show featuring J&J on NCTV 45 and on V3 TV in the UK. You don't have TV? Why not? You know, you never were a big, she was never a big TV person. That's okay. I totally understand.
Bob Newhart, yeah.
He
was good.
Yeah, you like Cosby? No, you. Oh, he called you up. Did you ever, if you don't mind us asking, I mean, I don't want to create any.
Don't drink the daiquiri, Mary.
Yeah, you did. Oh, you saw right through him, the kind of person he was.
Mm.
Oh, okay. Why? Oh, because he turned his back and he was going like that with the pills and you took a look over, oh, and you saw what it actually was trying to do. Wow, where was that at? At the Pink Elephant. Wow, that's a, where's?
You know, it doesn't necessitate, and I'm not trying to critique your interviewing style, Jimmy, but
yes.
Mary is giving up her time.
Yeah.
And I'd just like to be a little bit more efficient. You don't need to repeat her answers.
No.
I mean, the audience can clearly hear what she's saying. It's just,
well, I don't disagree with what you're saying to me. Okay, I know you're taller than I am. I get it. I don't know why. Are you angry with me? You're staring at me. I just don't know why she would stare at me. You'd rather have Jay interview you or? No, you're okay. Okay. Now, have you ever watched us, any of our episodes? Okay, I get it. You don't think we're funny. Because I could tell by the look on your face,
right.
You don't think
she's
fine.
Stoic.
Very stoic. That's a very good word. Mm-hmm. Austere would be another
good word. Yes.
Another good word. But But you are a nice, you know who you remind me of? She probably gets us a lot, Jay.
Mm.
Brigitte Nielsen. Remember, yes. She was married to Stallone for a while?
Yes.
And how about this? What? You want me to go to hell? Come on. I'm sorry. She's offended.
She had a torrid relationship.
With Stallone? With,
yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Okay, I didn't
know. We were told before the show, given the list of things we're not allowed to talk about.
Mike never gave me that.
Well, list. I got the list, and I went over that with you at the beginning.
Mary, I apologize.
Do not ask her about her skin condition either.
Tanning bed. Now listen, so then I tell you what, to really pick it up, and Jay, you'll probably agree with me. I think do you ever watch Fox? You don't. Well, just do me a favor. When you get a chance, Jay, Megyn Kelly. She's got the Megyn Kelly.
Yes, she does.
You do.
Mm-hmm.
I know you're taller than I am. Okay.
We get it.
That's twice.
We get it.
She mentioned that. I you got to calm down.
Mary, why don't you tell us about what we're doing here today? You can clearly see that Mary is working hard as we are getting ready for the spring line here at Main Street.
She's taking things out of the boxes. Can you tell us some of this stuff? That you have suits? I know what's coming up. This is a great place. Listen, did you know you could rent suits from Main Street? Did you know that?
Mm-mm.
Well, now you do. Mike told me that today. You could rent suits. If you don't want to buy a suit, which he has beautiful suits. In fact, he
buy the
sold.
Suit. Buy the suit.
You know what?
Buy the suit. Get it fitted. You'll never look better, guys.
What's? I don't have anything in.
You do, actually.
On my lip?
You do.
What am I? Ted Cruz? Do I?
Right there.
I got it. Listen. So, buy the suits. That's what I say because Donald Trump was here when he went over to Youngstown.
Yeah. Never made it out of the plane. No, I'm just joking.
No, he did. He was here. He came down, bought a couple suits from Mike because he knows. He's very well aware of Mike's business and his suits and his coats.
We politics. Mm-mm.
No.
Not allowed to talk about that.
Is that why she's not saying anything?
Yeah, she gets a little flustered.
Hmm. Well, let me ask you this. So, 30 years, when do you think you're going to be packing it in?
Obviously right now.
No way.
Because
no.
There are boxes on the...
Well,
there
no,
are boxes.
No, the box. No. Don't
there's
do her.
Boxes.
Oh, she's working.
She's packing it
in. She's working here at Main Street. Clothier?
That's what I say. It's clothier, I'm sure.
Clothier?
Yeah.
Well, you said you want to get back to work and that we should leave you alone and go talk to your friends over here?
Well, let's go talk to
I guess.
Larry. Or no, this is Mary and the other two are Daryl and Daryl.
Daryl and Daryl, the other two, Mike?
Yes.
I just woke Mike up.
He was sleeping in the back.
Listen, Mary, thank you very much. I know you're taller than I am.
Okay, Mary, that's enough.
Yeah,
all right.
Mary, calm down. You know what, Mary? I'm going to tell Mike you haven't done a darn thing, and we interviewed you, and you know what? You
okay,
were
cooperative.
Okay,
we're good.
You know
we're
what,
good.
Mary?
Cut.
Come on,
that's
Mary.
All right. That's all right. Let's go. Let's just.
Whoa, Mary.
And you knock it stuff over.
Man. Oh, man. Look at this guy.
That's a good look. That'd be a good look for you, Jimmy.
You know what? I kind of like lost his head. Life's getting to him. That's so stupid. That's an
old.
Let's talk to these guys.
All right.
Mike has a lot of great stuff.
A lot of great stuff.
Listen, let's give Mike a big shout out here.
Tuxedo rental.
He's got the Calvin Klein stuff. Look, free groom, 50%.
You get a free
$50
room.
Off. Not a room. You don't get a room at Mike's.
Oh.
Well, maybe he does have a room.
It said free room.
Going to the prom, all prom tux rentals. Come on, look how beautiful these things are.
I don't
want to
talk about prom.
Why?
Let's go.
Mary turned you down. Let's talk to these guys before we leave. Look at this. Where are you going to get nice clothes like this? Huh? Come on.
At
Where?
Main Street.
Clothier. At Main Street, yes. Yeah. Look, nice shirts. I'd wear this. This is like a Tony Soprano shirt.
Yeah, you would wear that.
Look at that. Isn't that nice?
It is nice.
Beautiful. Look, different color t-shirts. Look at this. Getting ready for the spring.
Oh, we got
nice.
A hipster look.
Yeah,
that's
look
the
at
hipster,
that.
New hipster look. Very nice.
And how about this?
Oh, we got
this
some Mike nice tweed.
Vavallo, look at that. Beautiful.
We got some nice tweed jackets.
He does tweed jackets. Ciani Cellini's super.
I'm
going
to have to.
You should.
Take a moment after we're done here.
Look, and he has jeans. If you want jeans, he's got the 505.
Levi's, no less.
Wait, Mary. Yeah, Mary. No,
we're
I'm
done,
not.
Mary.
Yeah,
we're done.
Please,
we're
get
done.
Your own water. I don't like the way you treated me. I complimented
I know.
Her too. I said you look like Megyn Kelly.
We offered it.
I offered it. Come on, let's go. Well, maybe.
Gentlemen.
Guys.
Can I talk
to you for a second? Excuse me, sir.
Larry. Or Mary. Daryl.
Daryl? May I speak? He's got a Trump hat on.
Yeah, he does. Well,
he does.
He kind of looks like the Don a little bit.
He looks like the Donald Trump.
Is that the one that's made in China?
Yeah, it's the one that's made in China.
Good, good.
Daryl, are you guys going to talk to me? What? What? Mike said what? Oh, whoa.
What are you looking at?
That. I know. What are we looking at?
They're staring intently.
He said he wanted to keep his eye out here because people have been throwing eggs.
Oh, because of the Trump hat.
Yeah, because of the Trump hat.
Wow.
How about, you know, I love this place down
here.
He's
fastidious.
Clothery and Custom Tailors, Curiosity Shop, Curious, come on in and see. Home of Rondinelli Tuxedo Company, right here downtown Newcastle. Isn't that great?
What's that?
Daryl.
What?
Can you... I don't understand this guy.
He said that's his dad, Ed.
Yes.
Hi, Ed.
Eddie.
Ed doesn't say much.
He doesn't.
Ed's the quiet man of the family.
Well, listen, come on. Let's. How much time do we have left here?
We have approximately 12 minutes.
That's all?
Yeah. What do you want to do?
Well, if these guys aren't going to talk to us...
I'll tell you what. I'll get a good view from out there, outside. You stand in here and interview them,
yeah.
And I'll get them from outside. I'll have a better shot.
All right, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, it's a good idea. Whoa, don't touch his hat. He gets very upset.
Oh,
He is funny. Isn't he? I told you, he's a cracko.
Daryl's hysterical. Well, here, I'll put his hat back on.
Yeah, that was in the notes. That was in the notes.
I didn't know
this
that.
Morning. Yeah.
This guy, he was talking about.
Well, we heard. We heard what, about the basketball. And
how'd you know that?
Because we could hear you.
You can hear us out here?
That was the whole idea.
Oh, I didn't know. You don't want
And I told you not to ask.
But he wanted money.
He's got an issue.
He said he needed.
He's got it.
Oh, well, good thing I took the money back off of him. Well, listen, guys.
Did he tell you about his boxing?
Oh,
yeah.
He did.
He was a wonderful boxer at one point.
But you know what? I heard he's working at the shoe store boxing.
Shoes.
Right. Or at the grocery store boxing oranges. Yeah. Okay. So, listen. Thank you, Daryl. Say hello to Dad. And can I talk to this guy out here? To the old class?
Sure.
Well,
sure.
Let's go out here, man. Again, Main Street Clothery. This has been great.
Oh, you want to talk to Juan?
Juan?
Yeah, Juan's a nice gentleman.
Hey, Juan. I'm over.
Maybe Spanish.
Hola. Parlez-vous français? Juan. You okay? Maybe there isn't any oxygen.
Oxygen. You know what?
We
should go talk to Mike about it. That's why they're so pale.
You know what?
That's why they're so pale.
Right.
Lack of oxygen.
I was thinking, He has them in his glass case? You know, lack of oxygen, that's something. Didn't they train Ham the monkey?
Correct.
Just to see his heart rate, check him out. Then they shot them with electricity.
Excellent.
Remember that?
Excellent point by you, yes.
All right, well, let's go over here then. Guys, we got Daryl, the dad.
Gentlemen, thank you.
Thank you. Go over here. How many fingers do I have? Come on, let's get out of here.
Now where are we going?
Well, I figured we could go back. Do we have a couple minutes left?
Yeah.
Come on, let's go back. Want to go back into the confluence?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen,
let's go say hi. Let's go say bye to Mike and tell him thank you and all that good stuff.
I think that'd be nice.
Hospitality.
Yeah.
A little disappointed with that whole thing, yeah.
There she is again. Hey, she just flipped me off.
Mary did. Yeah. Well, she's upset. I told you to not bring up
Should I say anything to
this stuff about, you know.
Hey, Mike, thanks.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Mary.
Nah. Thanks again, Mary, for
you
all
sure
your hard
work.
You
sure want a coffee or anything?
No, I'm good. Sue's making supper.
Oh, in the back?
Yeah. I can count on one hand the amount of times I've been out for.
Are you serious?
Well,
I told
here's
you
the thing.
Get you. Yeah,
we were told that if you don't make the food, you end up in the glass.
Oh.
Like Juan.
I see.
Gotta pull your own weight.
Yeah, I'm sure. Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate it.
Does your wife want a? Is that your wife? Want a coffee or anything?
No, we have a going back there. We have a microwave and a refrigerator.
Are you making anything for Mary? Does Mary? What
she's
does
sick.
Eat
much.
She's, huh?
Mary doesn't eat.
30 years.
She's not feeling well.
She's not.
Mm.
Wow.
She looks pale.
She does. Well, you said that before.
Yeah, I know. I've used that bit already.
Yeah,
sorry.
It's not funny. Mike's not even. Well, Mike is laughing. Look at Mike. You can't show the camera on Mike?
Well, I don't know if he wants to be on the phone.
Because he owns Main Street Clothery. We were bragging about all the nice... Look, he even has belts.
Okay, we'll put Mike on. He's going to have to sign that piece of paper, then.
No, he doesn't. Listen. Look, he has hats. Nice hats. Belts. He has great stuff here. You got to come down. People got to come down. Let me say this one more time. Mike, you said if you run out of suit, it's how much? $95?
Run suit's $95, yeah.
See, that's a great joke. But buy the suit, it's better than you always have the suit. Right. And then you were talking about sports jackets?
Yeah, we have sport coats, yeah.
Sport coats. You got to come down here. It looks nice. You go, hey, listen, you're in Newcastle, you get a sport coat. You want to go down?
Obviously, you're the epitome of style.
Well, it's because you said Mary wanted a mud wrestle with me sometime after the show. Well, that's neither here nor there.
You're prepping for that?
What else does he have? Oh, you get the sport coat, you put it on, you get on to Pittsburgh, or you can go up to Edwards, or you can go up to, what's another one of our sponsors, the Crane Room, Tuscany Square, right? You look nice.
Right.
He said you could wear the sport jacket with a pair of jeans. Come on.
That's how the kids are doing it nowadays.
That's what he was saying. Mike was saying that. Mm-hmm. Right here at Main Street, Clothery, Newcastle, downtown, right next to the Confluence. Are you getting this?
How can people get a hold of us?
724-510. What is it?
7345?
7345. That's NCTV
45.
Get in touch with Angelo. If, and you see, I really get this out there. If you want us to come to your business and do an episode, fine. If you want us to go to your house and do an episode, absolutely.
Nope.
No, absolutely not. If you want to meet Megan Kelly, she's right over there.
Nope, that's not
Fox
Megan Kelly.
On Fox News, she's on at 9 o'clock tonight. Nope. Megan?
That's Mary.
That's Mary. Yeah. Mary Kelly?
Nope.
Oh. All right, well, let's go. Mike, thanks again.
Thank you.
Pleasure. Thanks to your wife. You have a beautiful place here.
Thank
Ladies
you.
And gentlemen, you got to come.
See you, Mike.
Nice meeting you.
Thank you.
Plus with the tuxedos you need for the prom. Did you go to the prom when you were in
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh. Daryl?
Daryl, thank you, gentlemen. Excellent. Excellent work, Daryl.
Appreciate
you. No, Daryl doesn't. I told you, the cocaine habit.
Appreciate you.
Folks, we will see you tomorrow, mañana. No, not mañana, because that'd be Monday. Folks, we'll see you tomorrow on The Padula Show, Extra Freaks Ring. Jay and Jay, peace out.
Tonight, wait.
What? Oh, you all right? What? Tonight.
Yeah. Did you cut us off yet?
Autistic open mic night for the autistic featuring Nick Miller, the
Nick
autistic.
Miller, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Tonight.
Right, tonight.
Confluence.
At the Confluence, and that car will not be sitting out front. So. Okay. Folks, we'll see you tomorrow.
Whoa.
I said, folks, we'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, Mary will be on the show.
Quite contrary.
We'll be right back.